Hi developers. I've been using TwinCAT 3 more or less since it was released. And since then it has become such an integrated part of my daily work that it's my main software development platform. Spending thousands upon thousands of hours of developing TwinCAT 3 software for various machines over the years have given me many moments where I've felt that I'm on the top of the world, but also moments where I've been annoyed and thought that this has to be improved. I'm not the only person that has TwinCAT 3 software development as my daily work. This video is made in collaboration with someone that has vastly more experience in the field of industrial automation than me, and I'm very happy to have him as a guest in this video. I'll let Peter present himself.
Hi Jakob, hi everyone. Thanks Jakob for this invitation. I'm the CTO at the machine building company MTS Slovakia, where among other things I lead the Inkstand project. I've worked in industrial automation for about 20 years now, programming on different platforms from those known to everyone like Siemens, Schneider, to some more exotic systems. With my colleagues now, we take our collective knowledge into TC Open, which is an open source initiative happening on GitHub. As you may guess, I'm a great fan of Beckhoff's TwinCAT 3 platform. In this video, we discuss some of the features we would want to see in the next version of TwinCAT. We'll not talk about possible bugs and flaws and things that should work, but they don't. We hope they are being fixed as we speak. We rather turn our eyes to the future, TwinCAT 4, as a hypothetical future version of TwinCAT. So consider this to be kind of dreaming session.
Thank you, Peter. Before getting to the list, I want to mention that this list is not a complete list of everything that we would like to be improved. We just selected the number 4 because we thought that the title 4 things we want in TwinCAT 4 sounded catchy. This list is also not sorted in any particular order, and some of the things we mention here are closely related to each other. Without further ado, let's get started. The first change that we would want to see is for Beckhoff to switch to pure non-markup text-based files for their source code. When TwinCAT stores files, it does it in an XML format. This is a pain for several reasons. First, it makes version control harder. For instance, comparing two versions of a file requires you to adapt your eyes to skip all the XML markup, or to use a separate tool such as TC Project Compare. These type of proprietary tools can't be integrated into cloud software services such as Azure. On the topic of comparing different versions of the code, if files were stored in plain text, then the need for TC Project Compare would not be as important as third-party tools, which there are plenty of, could be used to compare files. Next, the XML markup makes code review more difficult. As projects get bigger and more complex, industrial automation projects have started to look at practices from the traditional software development, which includes to do code review of each other's code. When working in a cloud platform such as Azure in a software collaboration project, there are code review tools and they don't play well with TwinCAT 3 POUs. These platforms have no knowledge about that the source files are TwinCAT 3 files, but will just present them as raw XML files. Why the code reviewer has to painstakingly ignore all the XML markup while reviewing the code. This makes collaboration much more difficult. On top of this, the TwinCAT XE does what seems to me random changes in the files, such as changed GUIDs and TC file versions, which screws up the version control even more. Outside the world of automation, in almost every single other programming language in the world, source code is stored as simple text. Some languages, such as C and C++, have header and implementation files, while other languages, such as Java and Python, store all the code in one single file. In either case, these languages store all the code as simple non-markup text. There is no reason for TwinCAT not to do the same.
Many of you, I believe, love Windows Command Prompt, PowerShell, or Linux Terminal. We all know that feeling when we cannot remember the name of a command, and when we finally recall it, we certainly struggle to get the arguments right. However, CLI has some advantages. I mean, you can impress people by typing stuff into the console that no one understands, which makes you look smart, but besides that, you can automate the tasks. So what is the problem? TwinCAT has something called automation interface that allows you to do many things, adding new POUs, loading a PLC program, emitting the library, and plenty of other stuff. It is not so bad, but it is relatively slow as it needs the process of Visual Studio running in order to work. It is also not very stable as it depends on the configuration and the state of the particular instance of the Visual Studio. From time to time, you won't get the job done just because the VS has something else to do at that moment or get stuck in some unrelated activity. Why do we need to get better? Reliable automation is indispensable in automated continuous integration and continuous development environments. People now call it with a fancy name, DevOps. There is a set of practices developing software where your code is tracked, built, tested, and delivered in an automated pipeline. We use this practice for years in our framework and library development. There are constantly new additions, new features, and fixes coming from dozens of developers. We need to keep track and check that newly added code did not break something. It would be impossible to do it manually. We did need to find workarounds for TwinCAT to make it work. But still, it is not where we would like it to be. If you have a look at the pipeline we use in TC Open on GitHub, you may discover that some activities consume quite a bit of time. From time to time, the process just fails for reasons related to cumbersomeness of the process. For instance, to compile the project and emit the PLC libraries, we need to use Visual Studio. And that accounts for about 60% of the time, just opening and loading the solution. We also need to have the Visual Studio or the VS shell installed on all agents where we run the builds, which creates additional issues with updates and so on. Also, the footprint of the systems where we run the agents is also pretty big. There are also other areas where CLI would come in handy, like automated deployments of new code in the field. I know you, Jakub, developed script to do just that, and you run into similar issues as well. A CLI independent from a VS would also open a way of use with other editors and IDEs like Visual Studio Code, for example. And I'm sure the community would engage developing great tooling. And so the feature we would appreciate in TwinCAT 4 is a lightweight command line interface that can compile PLC project, emit libraries, install dependencies of the project, load the PLC program, and check for the state of the connect PLC.
Most of us that have been working with TwinCAT 3 have at some point or another been met with this window. What this window basically says is that the executable binary that you just compiled and that is on your development machine is different than the one that is on the target device that you are trying to log into. This window shows whether it is your intention or not to do an online change. And it's the times where it's unintentional that is the problem. One thing that Bekov has made unnecessarily complicated is the handling of different versions of TwinCAT. There are things like the remote manager, pinning and library freezing that takes care of part of the problem. But I've seen even seasoned TwinCAT 3 developers swear by their soul that they had not changed anything in the build chain of their TwinCAT 3 software, but still gotten this window to pop up. Add to the soup different versions of functions and supplements and their accompanying libraries, and you are entering a world of pain. Copy a project from one PC to another, and there is a good chance you won't be able to log in without an online change. There are too many conditions to be met. In a world where we get more and more built infrastructure as code, it's even more important to being able to reliably do a build completely from scratch. Many organizations already have a process and tool chain for building software and are now looking into how to incorporate the PLC software built into a similar pipeline. There simply has to be a way where I, as a developer, reliably can rebuild an executable for a target that is running a specific version of TwinCAT 3 over and over again on different machines, even if the target is running a 5-year-old version of TwinCAT. Here on my local laptop or on a build server in the cloud that was created just 2 minutes ago, based completely from a configuration file. In other programming environments, you often have build scripts that define the whole build environment for creating an executable. Now I know that Bekov have inherited parts of the problem from Codesys, because some of the stuff we are talking about here is simply how stuff is working in Codesys. such as the library management. So I'm not saying this is anything specific to Bekov and TwinCAT 3. What I am saying, however, is that the traditional software world has already fought this fight and overcome it. So it's time to look how it's done there.
This topic will be controversial and I will probably make some people angry. It's not the first time and I will have to live with it. There's a feeling that I developed over the years that leads me to believe that our industry is either over or badly standardized. It is not to say that the standardization is bad per se, but I think that there are good and bad ways of doing it. The way it is done in our industry is suboptimal to say the least. I'm referring here to different standards, but mostly, not exclusively, to IEC 61131-3. The first problem is that the standards are not being respected in the first place. It's not helpful when the standards are widely optional. The claim of inter-platform compatibility is a mirage that has never been fully achieved. The second problem is that the development of the standards is slow. Let's take IEC 61131-3. The standards are released every 10 years. 10 years is a too long time to set up the pace with the expectation and needs the industry has. If you look at the software standards in the last 20 years, they are updated way more often. ECMAScript yearly, the standard C++ Foundation every 3 years. I do not mean to offend anyone, but there is yet another problem. IEC is the International Electrotechnical Commission, and it is exactly that, electrotechnical. And the software standards mirror that mindset. This is not to demean the electrotechnicians. Our software could not run without them. They are, in a sense, more important as they provide veins and blood for any software solution we develop. The next problem is that the standardization reflects too many business and political interests, which weakens the technical aspects. This might be less evident in IEC, but it is definitely the case in OPC Foundation. What I can say with confidence is that the standards would look different had they been written by people who experienced sweat and tears working in adverse conditions in the field. So after this rather long prelude, what I would like to see in TwinCAT 4 is a modern programming language. Programming language is the key to improving the speed of development, the quality and maintainability over the lifetime of a project. Modern programming language would reduce the costs considerably. Getting back to IEC 61131-3, the OOP extension was a great move and it did help us a lot to develop better and scalable applications faster. However, it is an extension. The extension brings some inconsistencies, mixing concepts like function blocks and classes. You can pass complex types by value or by reference, depending on the type of var section. But when you use interface, you pass it as a reference no matter what var section you use. The implementation body of the function block is not clear what it's supposed to be. Is it a method? Is it a function? And there are many other inconsistencies in this extension. Here are a few features and properties the language should have. It should be multi-paradigm, object-oriented with some functional features like anonymous functions and lambdas. That would be great. It should implement generics, a method overload, a constructor overload. It should have modern and lean syntax, and compilers should allow for online changes and online monitoring. Now, Rome was not built over a day, and while we realize that some of these suggestions are quite big changes to how TwinCAT 3 works, we see them as a long-term goal. It would be nice to have them already in a future release of TwinCAT 3, but we can understand that if Bekov would consider these suggestions, they would make their way only in a major release of TwinCAT, maybe TwinCAT 4.
We're not saying that these changes would make TwinCAT perfect. Perfection is not static, it's a moving target. But we believe that with these changes we would be aiming in the right direction. Thank you very much for listening. What are your biggest issues with TwinCAT 3? And what would you want to see in a future release of TwinCAT? Please write your thoughts in the comments below. If you haven't already, then please hit like, subscribe to this channel, and see you in the next video.